attempt to speak on behalf of Maureen. Maureen, and let's all raise Maureen in prayer. I think she got a new knee. How's your mom doing? Great, great. So she'll be back with us soon. Great. So today's scripture lesson, did you guys listen to it? Do you remember what it was about? It was a man who gave something called talents to his three servants. Now, do you know what a talent was in the time of Jesus? A talent was a form of money. And it actually represented like a whole year's worth of pay. So this man gave each of his servants a lot of money. Now, this is a story that Jesus told, and Jesus' stories are called what? You guys know? A parable, yes. And a parable is a story. But Jesus, you know the frustrating thing about Jesus? He never really tells us exactly what it means. He tells us a story, and then he lets us try to figure out what it means, right? And so I'm going to perhaps have my own interpretation this morning. And what I think Jesus was saying is that God gives each of us some measure of talent. Now, who watches a program that has superheroes in it? Anybody? Jennifer, what do you watch? The Marvel comic shows? Okay, good. Good. None of you guys watch shows with superheroes? Who watches? Okay. Who watches PJ Masks? I thought so. Yeah. Who watches like Power Rangers? No. Delane, which superheroes do you watch? You don't watch any superheroes. Okay, I think, do you watch another one? The Justice League. Yeah, they just came out, right? Now, sometimes we think of these superheroes as somehow more than us, right? But I think what Jesus was saying in this parable is that God has given each of us superpowers. So, think for a minute, what's one thing you're really good at or that you love to do? Phyllis.
I like to write.
Phyllis loves to write. Evelyn. Jane.
Gardening.
Natalia.
Art.
Art.
Yes, you love to draw.
One thing?
Reading. Yes, you love to read. Now, when you are using those superpowers, Phyllis, when you are writing and you're just totally present to writing, and Natalia, when you are drawing and when you're reading, what's it feel like?
Okay.
Good. Can you give me another word? What is it about this thing?
Myself in it, I lose time and everything.
Yeah, you almost become more alive when you're using your superpowers. And these are your superpowers. Now, what does it feel like when you're not allowed to use your superpowers? Like, Natalia, if I were to say, you are not allowed to draw, what would that feel like? Yeah, frustrated, sad, maybe lonely, right? Yeah, and in the parable, one of the servants took the talent that his master gave him and buried it. It would be like burying your superpowers. Right, how could they? The other two took the talents and either shared them or invested them or made use of them. So Pastor Sally said a few minutes ago, sometimes living in community with each other feels risky. because it means we really have to share ourselves. We have to kind of sometimes take a risk with each other. And that's sharing your superpowers. So today, our lesson is to, first of all, recognize your superpowers and make use of them and share them with the people in your family and your friends and your community. Right? Okay, let's have a word of prayer. Lord, thank you so much for sharing your strength and your spirit with us so that we can live that out through our own superpowers here on earth. Help us to share those powers, to take the risk to be who we are, even sometimes when it feels like that's not welcome, so that we can be your hands and feet living out the kingdom of God here on earth. In Jesus' name, amen.